I think I really believe it, probably to an extent that I didn't before, after being in this program, is that not only can we make change, but that it will happen, because that's what people do.
It's made me a calmer person, a more meditative person, more thoughtful, mindfulness, and I examine things, everything, a little differently, and I'm not so quick to blame.
I feel like I can do something. You know, everybody has the power. I think if everybody had just cared a little bit, then that power can be amazing. So now, you know, I'm paying attention to everything. I'm giving my opinion. And when you give your opinion and you let your voice be heard, you know, I think that you feel empowered.
I learned that I am absolutely dedicated to peace and nonviolence in my life, more so than I ever thought I was. And I have really been able to develop and articulate my feelings about peace and nonviolence and how that applies to my everyday life in a way that I wasn't able to before.
It's very helpful to me. I apply it to almost anywhere I go. I apply it at work, at home, community, friends, anywhere I go. When they mention things that I could help them or inform them about what they don't know, I do share it with them.
The reason I created this program was, I think, born out of my prior work as a social worker, as well as the historical and political events that happened since I began teaching at Greenfield Community College. When 9/11 happened, of course, everyone was alarmed, and it created a whole different landscape. As a result, I began to think a lot about the implications, and then as we went to war in Iraq, really began to wonder about alternatives for us. And fortunately, at that same time, I discovered through the American Psychological Association that they had a Division 48, and it's the Division of Peace, Conflict, and Violence, and that the Psychological Association had in fact been doing research on peace and peacemaking and peace education. I subsequently attended a peace education conference in Canada, and it opened this whole new world to me about peace education and the possibilities that I could bring to this world in the position that I was in as a professor at Greenfield Community College.
I was standing in my living room while the news was on, and I said, you know, I gotta do something. I just can't stand here and watch it anymore. And I was a student here at GCC anyway. So when I came to register again and I saw that there was a peace and social justice option, I said, this is where I'm going to find some answers. This is where I can take some responsibility to try to change things.
I'd sort of always been into politics and activism, and I thought that it might be sort of a different approach to the work that I'd already been doing. So I decided to sign up for it, and then I just fell in love with the intro class and decided to keep going with it.
Not knowing what to do and getting back to the States, got a flyer in the mail from GCC about peace and social justice studies, and that just seemed to fit the bill for what I was looking for, because it was such a broad approach and covered so much of why certain problems exist and what you can do about them. So it was really kind of a lucky cosmic thing to have this flyer come in the mail and just, you know, saw it and thought, that's what I want to do.
In developing this program, I had to learn a lot. And that's what has really struck me about the importance of peace education, is that nowhere in my lifetime was I ever taught about nonviolence and about its power. And I held a lot of misconceptions about what nonviolence was and pacifism. And I think many of us do. And they are about the fact that it's a passive thing that doesn't work and that there's no power behind it. But the fact of the matter is, it is the most powerful force. And time again, what we haven't been taught historically are the times and places where people, either as individuals or groups, engaged in nonviolent action that was successful.
It sounds pretty sort of ambiguous, but then you start to throw in the fancy sounding terms like human rights or international law or all of that, and you say, and it's all of that, really, and nonviolence and everything. So it's, then people get it, I think, but it's a relatively new idea to study it from under that perspective.
Everything is connected, interconnected. We do study, start with family, actually start from ourselves, and then family, and our community, and then the country, and then the world. And it's really nice to know all these things, because learning about yourself is, it's healthy. It will change the way you view the world, the way you connect with your family and friends and neighbors.
The program is based in the Behavioral Science Division, and it's done purposely because it is about our behavior.
It's not being super specific like a lot of majors, and yet I think that that is sort of a really great contemporary approach to these problems. That's how we need to start looking at sort of global issues.
Usually I try to explain it as a study of both peace activists and non-violent activists in the history, and as well as sort of a study of the theories.
So we're looking at things from a historical perspective, an economic perspective, a political science perspective, sociology, anthropology, philosophy, religion, and take a look at the same questions from each discipline's point of view and perspective.
Definitely an interdisciplinary program. You can't talk about peace without talking about psychology or religion or politics, and you certainly can't talk about peace without talking about current events and what's happening in the world today, and your own personal beliefs about how you act in your everyday life.
It's important because I think social justice is going to be a big topic years from now, because the world is changing and changing. And I feel like, you know, people are looking out for someone who isn't, you know, worried about, you know, the world turning into hell, basically. So, you know, I feel like you learn about, you know, society, you learn about community, like I said. You just learn, you know, how to work with people, and you learn what the world should become and is going to become, you know, years and years from now.
Everybody asks the question, like, what can I do with a degree in peace studies? And the answer is there are some very specific things that you can do, but there are also, you can do anything with it. And that's the nature of a liberal arts degree anyway, is that you have a knowledge base that you're given that you take to whatever job you want to engage in. If somebody wants to go into business, the advantage of a peace studies and social justice degree is that they can develop their business practices based on issues about justice so that they're not harming the world. We see in a bigger scale right now the fair trade movement, for instance, and it's those sorts of practices that can be used. But you can also do specific things like go into social work or work for a non-governmental organization like Amnesty International or go into the Peace Corps. You can also focus on issues with the justice system and work in third-party dispute resolution or restorative justice practices. It's taking a look at each of the systems that we have created for ourselves and look at how we can create change within those systems.
Before I joined, you know, I didn't really know anything about current events. I didn't really know anything about the war. You know, I wasn't watching the news. I just didn't really care. And because I didn't care, I was just like, is there anything I can do? And the answer was usually no. But since I joined the club, I feel like I can do something.
There are four courses that are the main basis for the peace and social justice curriculum. The first one is Introduction to Peace Studies, and it really is a way for students to investigate some of the inherent questions involved in peace and nonviolence.
You get a lot of books, and it's a lot of reading. And the classes are discussion, and it's well-rounded.
very discussion oriented. There's a textbook that we read about theories about peace and violence and whether or not violence is a part of human nature or if it's something that we've created.
There's another class in conflict resolution and mediation, and it's a combination of the theory of conflict and understanding what the process of conflict resolution is.
I learn how to analyze the people around me. I learn why people do what they do and why do I react to their behavior and how they react with my behavior. I learn how to handle conflict.
It's a new way of thinking. I myself, you know, in conflict, would go right to being defensive and then eventually get angry and then it explodes the situation. With this, you think a little differently. You see, you look for a different approach to the problem and work it out. And when you speak to somebody that way, they don't get defensive either.
The third course is a psychology course, and it's the psychology of peace, conflict, and violence. And it investigates how and why people engage in some of the behavior that they do, and how some of those basic psychological processes can be used for more positive gain rather than negative.
Personally, you know, once I started the program, I think it should be mandatory for everybody. It's something that everybody should have, only because of the personal transformation that you go through, and you can take that into any field.
It's a program of self-discovery. I think it was more of a journey than I expected it to be. You can't really start talking about peace until you start thinking about what it means to you.
And the final one is peacemaking in practice, and that's a seminar in nonviolence and social action. And we study even more deeply the issues about nonviolence and really begin to understand what it is and the power behind it. And there's a required service learning component so that the students have to actually go out and practice different forms of nonviolence.
The actual subjects that you're learning about are enriched by a diverse student body and a variety of opinions and different experiences.
So we communicate and learn from each other, which is very, very important. Interaction with other students and teachers is very helpful because there's so much to learn from them.
You know, every day we would come in and talk about what we'd been doing and, you know, tell our stories about what we'd been up to and the challenges that we'd face. And more often than not, another student would have had a similar experience that they talked about, and it would tell us how they had dealt with it and, you know, give advice about how to approach certain situations or challenges in working with peace.
So the final thing I want to say is that learning about peace and nonviolence and how to do things differently, how to solve our problems in a way that doesn't cause harm but actually meets people's needs, is absolutely vital and important today. I think we're at a real turning point in our civilization, and we have some very big choices to make. And I see the program as also being a chance and an opportunity to learn about getting involved in your community, getting involved in your life around you, and having some actual say in what happens to you. Instead of just looking to our leaders only to change things and solve our problems, we need to do this ourselves.
I don't know, for me it was just the right thing to do. I felt like I was doing something better for myself and the world.
I have learned so much from Abbie and this school. I would share and help other people and use everything I could use or what I've learned to other people in order to help them.
When I'm studying peace, it just makes me open up my eyes and realize all the horrible things that are happening in the world. But other days, I just feel so blessed to have the opportunity to study something that most people don't, and to have be surrounded by people who feel the same way that I do.
Before, you know, I was just thinking, what can I do to help save this world? But now I think slowly but surely, hopefully I can make the world a better place, one person at a time.
It's been incredibly inspiring for me to realize that, you know, people my age, from all different backgrounds, with all different experiences, all really crave the same things for our future.